Hey guys, DT Gaming. So, I'm going to be working on a fishing rod here. This is a Savage Gear SG4 Spinning Rod. So, I'm making this rod because it was basically requested by another person that asked me if I could make this. I think his name is Zeke. I do apologize if you get upset for me using your name. But yeah, he suggested me to try to make this rod because he said that it looks pretty sick. And you know what? It actually does look pretty good. It looks like it kind of reminds me of, is that plastic? Anyways. I'm looking at some things on here, a few things I could do. We'll start off over here where this point is. So what we're going to do is we're going to come over here, grab a cylinder, and we're going to drag right down here. And then with that, we'll turn the angle snap on. Rotate this 90 degrees. I turn that back grid off because I don't want that on. Alright, so I want to get rid of the height segments because I don't want the segments at all. And I'm going to collapse this down to edible poly. Now we'll apply a material to this. So we can at least make this transparent. I also want to make this darker so I can see the lines better. We're going to put about 35. Fat. We'll start shaping this. Now, we're looking at this at a perspective view. See how it's curved on here. So this is being looked at an angle. It's not completely straight because otherwise you won't be able to see this if it was flat like this, like, you know, straight. Anyways, so how we're gonna do this is through here. So what we're going to do, we're going to bring this all the way to the end right here. And we're just going to try to match this as possible. Like I said, we're looking at this at an angle. So this is going to be off. We're just going to line it up here. Actually, I'm going to pull this down some to about right there. There. This way, the thickest part up here is up here. That way I can. And that matches pretty good. So I like to start creating edges here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn the ribbon thing on here. I want to flap this down so I can get these controls. I'm going to click on edge so I can get the edit tool to pop up. Right click this, add it to quick toolbar, which is going to be up here. Flaps it off. So now I can just click right here to start creating detail. But we'll get to the rest of that here after. Now I just want to start extruding this downward. All right, now we can start shaping this out. Now, so if we look here, there's like it's like kind of like a separate part up here. It looks like it's separate. So what we're gonna do is we're going to chamfer this edge right here. Let's do a quick save because sometimes things you do don't always work out the way you want to. So we're gonna bring this into full view. Excuse me. We're going to extrude this inward like so. Side of that, ring, we're going to connect two loops inside. We want to make it tight as possible, so we're going to do about 95 should be fine. We want to do the same for the sides. Want to create a loop in here, an edge as close as possible to the end. So instead of using two, we want one. Again, we want to use about 95. Or in this case, it's a little bit tighter, about maybe 90. About 98, or actually, yeah, 98 would be fine. You want to do the same in here. Okay, so what this did is that we add a smooth modifier, right? Ignore the end right here, because we'll fix that. We got that gap right there. Now it's kind of this edge right here maybe needed to be pulled out more because it's kind of more of a chamfer like. Wanna pull out some, but right there. All right, so one thing I noticed that this is too wide. About right there. Alright, so that looks good so far. We'll do a quick save. We'll get rid of that modifier. Okay, so let me pause the video for a moment because I need to look for something here. Okay, so I found what I was looking for. I just want to bring it into view here. So if you look at this, there's like a little thing here. This is Savage Gear. Now I don't think I'd be able to make this right here. Try. I need to find a logo so I can do something with it. So give me one moment. Okay, so that I'm looking for. However, the logo don't really quite match what is on the end of that rod here. I mean, this part matches right here, but this part here don't. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna copy this right here. Create new. Now, I kinda wanna make the canvas a little bit larger than it's supposed to be. So about 6. I'll make this about 6 as well. Place this here. Okay. Alright, we're gonna make this ourselves. Text. We'll just make it black. Savage. Different font. Matches that. I think we're going to do with this cap lock. You know, it kind of looks like this one text right here. I'm going to call it pilot command. Oh, yeah, that's definitely it. All right. So now he's got to create an arc on this, like so. Down. Make this bigger. I kind of want to make that black as well, so we're going to Alright, then we create a new text down here. Gear. Arc, but we want to do this backwards. Now, I know it's not looking exactly the same. But we're doing our best. So we want this like minus 56 for the gear. That want to merge this together. Then you can center this. Okay, stay as. Okay, so that should be usable. I actually do want to save that in case I need to. Nope, actually, I don't have to save it. I mean, it don't really have to match, it's got to basically look the part. Anyway, we're done with that part. So now we can go ahead and create this hand handle part right here. So now what I want to do is create this right here. This don't look the same though. Actually, it does, actually. Alright, so let's make this transparent again. Or now we get this exactly line up but right there. And then we gotta create another loop in here. One right here, but one right there. This one, you don't have to go as deep. We want to do extrude, but not so deep. But it's about right there. We'll do the same thing we did with the other one. Two segments. Actually, no. We'll just double click these edges. And we'll just chamfer it. Like that. So we add in our smooth modifier. This should actually look like it's supposed to. Ah, come on, Maul, stop doing that. And again. So we kind of got like another one right here, exact same thing. So we want to. Oh. Right here. But right there. Same thing. Well, 5. Got these edges here. Sample. Okay, now we'll create that end part. Hide that. I close that off again. Ugh. So we want to flip this back part. We want to create inset. Like right here. We want to kind of push this in like so. And this edge right here, we got to chamfer that. Now it seems that this end part is kind of a little bit tapered. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll this right here. scale that down just a little bit. Now you can see it's kind of has a little bit of extruding here with inside. And over here we'll start extruding up in like that. I'm going to inset the back end part right here. Chamfered ends here. This one in here, we've got to do a little bit more. It's a little bit more smoother around. Okay, so now if we add the smooth modifier back, you see exactly what that looks like in there. I'm gonna actually grab this whole entire set of polygons and because this is actually flat. There we go. So, this one is pretty different than that picture here. Ah, I just realized something here. I can fix this, I think. Just realize I made a mistake. Should be an easy fix. I want to set all these. Kind of want to extrude out like so. Kind of a little bit too deep, actually. I mean, okay, so we're starting to get that shape back here. A little more better. Okay, so that part's done. Now I just want to work on this end here. Do a quick save. That now we want to work on this. Now we see a very, very faint line here. We want to add that. And over here on this end. Unhide that. Yeah, there's that faint line, so we'll use this line right here. Oh. We want to chamfer this. Like that. Grab that little bit there. Want to extrude that very, very little bit, but right there, here, bring this. We're going to create that 85. We're going to make it like tight in there. We're going to select this edge. This edge. Want to chamfer that a little. Like, but right there, that should give us that faint line that we see. It's still steep. See what happened, get rid of those lines. Yeah, I think that will be okay. You still see that line though. I mean, it's too deep. I mean, there we go. That's very subtle right there. That's what we're looking for. Okay, now I'll create this end part right here. I'm actually going to push the plane back. Right here. It still looks where it's supposed to be right here, but I want it back here so I can see the full model here. I have to create that edge, otherwise I'm going to get this weird coloration there that don't belong. So we want to inset this like so. up here we want to create a chamfer. Oh. Create a little sharper edge up here. It's not, it needs to be sharper than that. This part going to switch. I'm gonna save this real quick. Inset. Again, we want to do a tight chamfer here. I want to create a line. Alright, this I want to chamfer because it's kind of a little smooth right here. Like that. You want to do another inset. Okay, so we're gonna come on this side. They just want to drag this whale over here. What right there? Looking good so far. I will actually push this in some. We want to extrude this. So it actually looks like it is attached, but is it attached? Alright, so let's hide this. Well, make it transparent again so we can work on this part. I can't really see the, this looks like right here, but I have to look at it from here. We got a little bit, actually from what it looks like, this is kind of, way extruded out right here. So what we're gonna do, actually redo that. We might actually delete this end part and recap it. The boat right there. There. All right, so let's start working over here. Want to chamfer that edge right here. This is where that silver edge is going to be going. I think we want to do a chamfer here. So. Now we want to try to match this way it looks. That's what we do. I don't want to do it the opposite though. No. Could do, actually. Yeah, actually, that should work. We can actually just copy this whole thing right here. do, we're going to drag this over here. We want to clone this to element. We want to flip that. We want to that. I'll go ahead and actually delete that. So what we're going to do is that we can't have that there. So now all I do is just grab these and weld the start welding. Make sure it's closed. Yep, okay. One thing I know is more difficult actually with this part. Actually, I'm just going to do this. I'm going to undo all that. I'm going to separate that, delete that. Because I just need to grab this right here on the end. Like that. Basically just make a copy of this element, flip this so then we'll weld those. Uh, tool. There we go. Let's do a quick save here. We want to start doing this. Here. Okay, now extrude. About right there. Okay, after that. I should be fine with that being at that depth. This does kind of look a little bit deeper from the picture. So actually might be quicker just doing it this way. Okay, I think we're gonna have to make a separate model for that part. Because the fact is, this is kind of different if you see. Turn that guy straight off for a moment. All right, so kind of want to do this separate here. So I think I'm gonna do, wanna grab this. Oops. I gotta turn that constraint off, by the way, it can't let me do it. So I want to add this as a different object. So what the hell do you call that thing? I say name it cylinder 002. Let me create a shell modifier here. Well, let's see how this goes, because I don't know. This might not work where I want it to work. No, I'm not gonna try to get it to match as closely as that. It'd be too, just trying to do it this way is wouldn't be challenging. Alright, let's see. Looks like yeah, it looks pretty good. This is where we start making this part right here. Now I removed the polygons in here because I need to start shaping this up here. Otherwise, I'd not be able to do this right. Thank you. I actually need to copy that. Oops. Yeah. No, I'm gonna lose. Wait a minute. So we'll keep it like that. And what we're going to do. Keep this side part. Then I'll put a border here. We'll cap that off. Okay, I want to bunk one on there so we don't look white. It still don't look right. Why it look like it don't fit? Well, actually, actually, it does kind of match pretty good. So I think what I want to do now, I kind of want to just grab a copy of this, bring it over, like so. We'll name this cylinder. I need to put a rather smooth modifier on it because I'm keep getting weird artifacts on this. Hopefully this gets rid of it. There we go. here. Okay, I want to start extruding this. What right there? With you. Yeah, that actually might work. It don't really match the with. It's doing that because the wife's doing it. It's doing that.
well.
I can't figure this out. Oh, I see what you're doing. That one. No, I should be able to work that. What's this doing? Hmm. Could have just did it the other way because it just ain't working. Let's do a extra save here. I'm just going to do it this way. I think it kind of looks better this way. It kind of matches too. So I'm going to actually symmetry this. Ah, Christ. Come on, guys. Some odd reason, the program just crashed. Well, then crashed for some odd reason I couldn't even control the pivot point, which I needed to. No, I could do this. Symmetry. Flaps. I think this was the only way I can divert that problem. I mean, it still looks good though. Can't do that. I gotta take that border here. Oh, So I want to attach that. Hey, what the hell happened here? I see what they're doing. I didn't copy all that. I mean, inspect all of it. Ah, dang it, the edge loop is gone. I bet I just sealed that. Yep, I did. Okay. Why is it like half shown? I actually pull that out more. Something don't look right with this part. It just seems like it's bent or something. Alright, so I think Zap will do it for now. I'm gonna cap that. There we go. I'm just gonna do this for now. We'll finish this later on. Start working on the rest of the pool. Anyways, if you guys liked the video, make sure you hit that like button. You guys want, you guys should subscribe as well. Appreciate support. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys.